that's all.
Okay, so here we are at Starbucks Holland Village, and we are going to try to go around island. So we're going to start on the middle, head down, hit the west coast. Hit the west coast, go all the way. This is Pandan Gardens there, right?
Yeah,
that Tuas. Yeah. Depends on whether you want to turn up straight away to NTU or go all the way to Tuas Lighthouse. Okay, depends on mood lah. Then if you want more adventurous, can go all the way to the South Point, which I've never been. I don't know if you guys can go. Okay. Then after that, you go up. Okay, this one's standard. But one of the areas we have to hit is the Seletar area, where there's the new Wheeler's Estate and all that, restaurants and all that stuff. It's quite cool to look at. Yeah, so there's a bike cafe there as well. Then finally we carry on Pasir Ris, Punggol, and the usual area. This part boring a bit. This part a bit weird because I don't know how the road is now. You know, they changed a lot of the road structure over here after Changi Village.
Yeah, it's still just straight down. It's still just straight down. Yeah.
But it's just no shelter lah, no trees lah, right? Yeah. But in the afternoon, I saw that it will likely rain and all that. So after 12 or 11 onwards. Then all the way down here, that's that we'll call it ready.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
Alright. Then we'll kena casinos at the Marina Bay area.
Oh yeah, yeah. But on bikes, it should be okay. Bikes. Okay, cool. Alright, signing off. Peace. Our bikes are. So Melvin Cheng here rides Brompton, and it's a very nice, this is which year? 2016, right?
2016, yes.
Yeah. So is this the black edition?
Yeah, the 2016 black edition.
Black edition, and it's got the very nice floral color to it. He's even got a very nice Brompton bag from Korea, right?
Yep.
This one's nice because it's got mole kind of Velcro and all that, and it looks like higher capacity also.
Yeah, the largest one.
Wow, this what? How much the volume?
How much? I don't know. I really don't know.
It looks almost
the same size as the largest Brompton one.
Okay, so either 40 to 60 liters or something. Yeah.
And you can roll top four, extend until here actually.
Wow. So yeah that's huge. Yeah. And then it's got the nice pockets at the back also. Bottom. Very good. Good bag to get. What's the name of it?
Blue Sprite the brand.
Blue Sprite brand. Yeah. Okay, cool man. It's riding the Krampus. Surly Krampus, and he's painted all black. So what have you done to it?
Actually nothing, just
this is the standard build.
Yeah, the standard build. Just the color change. That's it.
So this is a 3-inch tire, so it's what people consider a semi-fat bike, all terrain, and it's designed for trails, so it's quite fast rolling as well. Very agile. Okay, cool. Alright, Jason here rides the
Santa Cruz.
Nomad.
Yeah, it's all mountain. And then we've got the Fox Talus with the 160 travel. This brake. It's mainly you can go and trash in the mountain.
Yeah, and this is a 26er, right?
Yeah, it's a 26er.
Yeah, so it rolls fast, good for climbing, all that.
Yeah, and titanium rail spring.
Wow, that's crazy.
Yeah, it's crazy.
Right.
Yeah, the previous owner is there. This is
fine.
<his
bike. laughs> Okay, cool, man.
Yeah.
Is it recording? Yeah, it's recording.
Okay, can we introduce?
Hi. So I'm riding the Specialized AWOL Polar Edition. So that's why it's orange with some designs on it. Front loading rack with two panniers. This is what they call adventure bike. It's one of the things that kind of kicked off during the craze of all the gravel racing and all that. And the beautiful thing is people making all these bike bags, frame bags that mount all over to utilize the space on a bike to store equipment and stuff. So we got food, battery packs and all that. I love this because whenever I go out long rides, at least you got everything with you. I like to be prepared with tools, raincoats and all that. Next time we'll try camping and all that, and should be really fun. Even though it's got knobbies, but because it's about a 29er, which is about 700c, it rolls very fast, that's why it's got drop bars and all that. So it's like a bike that can do it all also. So very fun.
Well, care to share what is this?
Oh yeah, this is the Thud Buster. So, you know, for people, because it's a hardtail bike, no suspension, this kind of helps cushion because it's elastomers here. And basically the whole thing can sort of retract backwards and forwards, like a little suspension system for your butt. Alright, previous owners, Mikael. So thanks a lot, Mikael. So this is one of the first bicycle bridges around Singapore that goes over the expressway. I believe it's the AYE. and we're kind of near between Clementi and Jurong already, and this is probably the Pandan Gardens area. So they've split up the lanes as shown. You can see there's a up down for the cyclists and a separate track for the runners, joggers as well. So this is quite nice, and one of the nicest bridges around for cyclists, and hope that they'll build some more in future if it makes sense. Alright, see ya. Okay, we are now on Jalan Buroh, past Pandan Gardens, heading towards Tuas. And you can see that actually there's a lot of trucks today. Today is a Saturday. Not exactly a good time to ride on this industrial road. So we might abort Tuas and head straight for the jetty. Yio Chu Kang, Neo Tiew, Kranji area. Alright, so see you. About along the Tuas route, and this bridge actually leads to, if I'm not mistaken, Jurong Island. Yeah, Jurong Island. And over there on the top, you can see there's a little building, round cylindrical building. That's the top of Jurong Hill, which is behind Singapore Bird Park. So I'm thinking that we go up the Jurong Hill instead, lah. Because today's ride down here is pretty nasty.
Yeah.
So we'll just find a way to get across. Okay, so that's where we'll go. Oh really?
Yeah.
Have you gone up the hill with us last time?
No.
Oh, we're going up the hill. For Melvin, it's going to be xiong. He only has 2 speed.
Xiong.
It's about 10, right? You willing to try?
Slowly long.
It's not that high.
Yeah, slowly long.
Okay,
I'll
so
go,
we're...
I'll go ahead. I cannot touch.
Okay, we're now at Jurong Bird Park, and there's this Jurong Hill, which is a much forgotten place. There's a very nice building on top. Great view of Jurong Island and the rest of West Coast. So going in there now. So we're on top of Jurong Hill. There's still a building behind us which you can go up. But here's the view that you get. It's quite nice. This is pretty much the west of Singapore. Bukit Timah here in the distance over there, the antenna. And here's all the Jurong Industrial. And then over there is Jurong Island, where they do all the oil refinery and all that. It's a restricted area. Well done! So this is the Jurong Port and Shipyard. Okay. And yeah, we're on top of this very old building, which we have no idea what they're gonna turn it into. But yeah, from here we'll take a little break and then carry on northwards through Yio Chu Kang. Is it Choa Chu Kang? It's Choa Chu Kang, right?
Choa Chu Kang
and then Neo Tiew. NTU, Choa Chu Kang and Neo Tiew. I keep calling Yio Chu Kang.
Lim Chu Kang.
Oh, Lim Chu Kang. Yeah, I keep getting it mixed up. Yeah, Lim Chu Kang Cemetery.
Wow, that's so...
Okay, we're just outside NTU at this point. And you can see that if you haven't been here for quite a while, the west side, the road has been reconstructed. And you can see it's kind of brand new. Maybe it's more straight or something, I don't know, but they've widened the lanes and all that, I think. And we're on our way to Lim Chu Kang Cemetery area. After that, it will go to Neo Tiew. So this is heading northwest, and we'll check in a while. One thing about this Lim Chu Kang stretch is that it can be very pleasant, very relaxed, very serene. So it's a very nice escape from Singapore in a way. gonna turn up on this new Tew Road, which is heading towards Sungai Buloh Wetlands. Any further straight and you'll go to Punggol Jetty, which is not where we want to go today because our friend is on a two-speed Brompton. It's not fun. Very nice farms here in Kranji, and basically all these farmers have kind of like, it's kind of like their last stand in a way. So they banded together and formed this thing called Kranji Countryside or something like that. There's a website for it, and they try to promote you know, like farm and eco-tourism and all that here. So they have fairs, farmers markets and all that kind of stuff happening. So we just gotta click on that. Now at Bollywood. Is it Bollywood? Yeah. Bollywood Veggies, which is a farm and
Indian vegetables.
Indian vegetables, why Indian specific? But anyway, there's lots of wonderful vegetables here, and you can see that there's actually a restaurant and you can have fun in there. It's part of the Kranji Countryside Association of Singapore, part of the Heritage Trail. And there's actually a bus, I think, called the Kranji Express. I don't know.
The cafe is called Poison Ivy.
Oh yeah?
Yeah.
Want to go in and take a look? Just a quick one?
Yeah.
Okay, we haven't been here before, so we just take a quick look. Alright, cool. We come out of the new Tew area, which is the Kranji farm area. We arrive at the Kranji dam, which is like this, and looks very nice actually. And Johor is just across the water straits there, and there's a lot of development happening right now. So this whole area, the Serenity, all that, probably is gonna go soon. Lots of urban development happening. Here's what the Johor looks like from over here. Been a long time since I've been to Johor, and it's developed quite a lot. It's quite amazing. This is the site which I believe, not sure, but is this facing Yishun side? Not sure. Anyway, I think there's a golf club over there somewhere. And in front of us will be the Kranji industrial area. And also kind of where Woodlands is, and where the start of the railway used to be. So those historians amongst us know that there's a green corridor kind of starts somewhere in there. Okay. And they've redone quite a bit of the road as well as the buildings here. Alright, they demolished some of the buildings that used to exist here. And there used to be, I believe, like British barracks over here in the early days. So they've turned things around, they've added new roads, widened the roads. And in front of us, along the way, on left and right side of the road, there's actually a railway track that was removed already, but the green corridor remains. So can't remember exactly where it is, but it's around here. I think there's a historical marker as well to indicate. We're going through the Singapore Turf Club at Woodlands, and it's about 16 kilometers more to Seletar Air Base. That will be our lunch stop, and we're looking forward to that because there's Wheeler's Estate over there, which is a very nice bike cafe, restaurant, etc, etc. Okay, so see you then. The reason why that Mandai climb is something that all cyclists have to go through, because this route that we just took, which looked alright from a car GPS point of view, actually leads all the way through expressways, and it was impossible for us to get in. Now we're going to try our luck to see if they'll let us in through Singapore Turf Club, because that's how we saw an uncle kind of get through, make it across to the other side of the Turf Club. Alright, cool. So we can't go in through the Singapore Turf Club. Well, that was expected. So now we're going to take the long route through, I believe, the Admiralty, MRT and all that. up the long Mandai stretch and then head towards Salida. Alright, see you. We're kind of in Woodlands right now, and still a long way to Salida to go through Yishun and all that. Sunoco, so still a long way. So beautiful, right? But everybody's playing Pokemon. Pokemon Go! Anyway, it's a beautiful day, not too hot, and you can see Johor so clearly. High tide right now, so it's quite beautiful actually. You can see the causeway over there. And there's a restaurant in front. Melvin, there's a restaurant in front, right? What's that? Huh? Yeah! Looks like a restaurant. Looks like they've been developing quite a bit. Rasa Istimewa Waterfront Restaurant. Looks pretty awesome.
I saw a boy come in.
Nice. That's a Sunoco power station, I believe. Admiralty Road West, and there's a lot of colonial houses here, and the names of the roads are pretty cool. They're all, you know, in the like Falkland, Ottawa, Auckland, all of those European countries. So for these houses, you basically have to rent from the government, but they're very beautiful and serene in there. We are now somewhere in Sembawang on a PCN that connects us to Yishun, and then after that the Salida Dam, hopefully. So we're on Yishun, I think some new road, not very sure. We turned in from Yishun Avenue 7, and now there's this new road here with new path here, and it goes direct to the Salida Dam that leads us to Salida Air Base. The Yishun connecting to Salida Dam or bridge, and it looks really busy today for some reason, so we're on the side of the road, but it's not very easy to ride like this, so we're gonna try and get onto the road. Yeah, it's very hard. Okay, there are planes here, which means that we are at the Salida Airport, and we're now at the outer perimeter, so to get in we kind of have to go through the front, which is facing southwards, but to work our way around it. I don't think we can just cut through like this. We are kind of near Salida Airbase, and you can see that they've got more F&B options that they've started here. I don't know which one is this. Oh, this got Young's, and very nice for cyclists. Then, there's even a Chinese restaurant there. And I think Wheeler's Estate is just in front. Okay. Yeah, it should be over there. So this whole place is very cyclist friendly. This is the summer house. So this is a different place. There's so many options here, it's pretty crazy. So from a sleepy airport kind of deal, suddenly now it's got more life. It's great because it's a repurposing of the colonial buildings that were here. Don't put them to waste. Okay, we'll explore a bit and let you know. from cycling to aeroplane to makan. Beef rendang.
Rendang.
Beef rendang. Nothing.
Cherry.
Tired and decided to just call GoGo Van to take us home. Anyway, this is what the rest of Silitai base looks like. This is Old Birdcage Walk Road. And it's actually very nice. There's a little marsh here as well. But yeah, the mission failed. We were just going to head back now.